So in this screencast, we'll be talking about how to implement an F-test in MATLAB and in Excel. And what I'm showing on the left are two samples, both of which have a sample size of 5. So 5 different measurements from each of the two samples. And here's a graph of those two samples so we can visualize it graphically. When you perform an F-test, what you're really asking is how likely is it that the data points from the two samples came from distributions with different variances. So these values I pulled in my computer program, I pulled them both from a normal distribution. The question is, did I use a distribution with a larger variance for sample 1 than I did with sample 2? And when I look at these, I say, yeah, probably. I look at the spread of the data in sample 1 and note that that is larger than the spread of the data in sample 2. And before I even do the F-test, I'm apt to say that I do think that they came from two populations with different variances. And indeed, that is the case. For sample 2, my computer program, I sampled from a normal distribution that has a smaller variance than the distribution I used for sample 1. But remember, in real life, you never get to know this. We never get to know the true distributions. All you ever see are these data points. So in MATLAB, I've already entered the arrays for X1 and X2, my two samples. And when I run it, remember that the spread or the distribution for X2, the variance for X2, is going to be smaller than the variance for X1. And it looks, that gives us an argument that the distributions are indeed different, the variances are different for it. So let's test that. The function we use is var_test_2, and I'm going to use two arrays, X1 and X2. When I implement that, it says the answer equals 1. Well, what does that mean, answer 1? What it means is that at alpha equaled 0.05, we can reject the null hypothesis that the variances are equal, and it provides evidence that the variances are indeed different. So let's do this. We can calculate that value 1. We'll store it as h, but we really want the p-value from the f-test. So I'll do var_test_2 again with x1 and x2. And this will return h again equal to 1, but this returns the p-value, and that p-value of 0.04 is indeed less than our selected value of alpha of 0.05. Var_test will default to alpha equal 0.05. If I change it, I can also say, let's set alpha equal to 0.01, for example. Now when I run it, the p-value is greater than 0.01, and this means that with a value of alpha of 0.01, we cannot reject the null hypothesis. It will say the evidence now is not strong enough to indicate a difference in variance. So that value of alpha, remember, is entirely up to you. But typically, people will use alpha of 0.05. Here's how I set it up in Excel. I've got my two samples, sample size of 5 in both cases. We want to run an F-test to get the p-value to figure out if the variances are different. So I'll use f.test, and F-test accepts two arrays. So the first one will be sample 1, and the second array will be sample 2. I'll close off the parentheses and push enter, and I do get the same p-value, which suggests it's significant below alpha of 0.05, but insignificant if we chose alpha of 0.01. Here's a different situation. I've again pulled random numbers from a normal distribution for sample 1 and sample 2. We want to ask ourselves, is the underlying variance from the two populations, are they different or are they the same? So let's run an F-test on these two samples. So in MATLAB, we'll do the same thing, var_test_2 for X1 and X2. And I return a p-value of 0.61. H is 0, which means we cannot reject the null hypothesis. It looks like measurements for both samples come from two populations with the same variance. I could do the same thing in Excel. Let's paste sample 1 and sample 2. I've entered the numbers for the measurements for both samples. We'll put the p-value here, and again, it's just f.test. I'll push tab to auto-complete it, select the first array, and select the second array, and that returns the same p-value as we saw in MATLAB, this 0.61307. That large p-value of 0.6 suggests that the measurements from the two samples came from populations that did have the same variance. And as it turns out, that is the case. I chose two normal distributions with the same standard deviation for both. And those variances are indeed the same, and that agrees with what we came up with for the F-test. Here's a third situation, two samples with 5 measurements for each sample. We want to figure out, is the variance for this sample different than the variance for this sample? Did the measurements come from populations with different variances? And when I look at this, it looks to me like they probably do, but we don't know for sure. When I run these in MATLAB, I come up with a p-value of 0.034 or 0.035, and that suggests that we can reject the null hypothesis. It says that the variances are likely different between the two populations. And the p-value for MATLAB agrees with the p-value that we come up with for Excel, about 0.034, 0.035. Just remember, though, that statistics is a matter of probability. It only gives us the likelihood that they came from underlying populations with different variances. So here, a graph of the data again. We look at it. Sample 2 looks like it came from a population with a higher variance than sample 1. As it turns out, though, they came from populations with the same variance. Even though we've rejected the null hypothesis based on these data, we suggested the variances were different. What we did was incorrectly reject the null hypothesis. And in doing so, we've made a type 1 error. So just keep that in mind when you run an F-test. It provides evidence, but it never provides conclusive proof. And if you remember, we don't ever get to see these actual underlying distributions. We can only make some inference. We can only report the likelihood that they're different. And the take-home message is the smaller the p-value, the higher the likelihood that the two variances are indeed different.